The NBA is that one professional sports league where it seems like all the superstars are on great teams. That's probably because guys like LeBron James and Kevin Durant are always forming super teams with their superstar buddies. Mind you, there are only four or five elite NBA teams every year, and each of them are loaded with stars. That being said, there still are some great NBA players that don't earn as much attention, because their teams don't do a lot to help out. I'm Justin Fraction, and today we take a look at 10 great NBA players who are stuck on horrible teams. And we do hope you enjoy this video, and if you do, feel free to click subscribe down below for more cool videos every single day. Number 10, Eric Bledsoe. The veteran point guard would probably be the first to tell you he misses his days as a Los Angeles Clipper, where he could actually compete for championships. Mind you, he didn't emerge as a star until he joined the Phoenix Suns in the 2013-14 season. He posted career highs in points and assists with 17.7 and 5.5 per game, respectively. In 2014-15, he posted 6.1 assists and 17 points per game. Then he got even better in 2015-16, scoring 20.4 points and 6.1 assists per game. The only problem? The Suns haven't made the playoffs since 2010, when Steve Nash was in town. Number 9, Brook Lopez. Lopez has been a mainstay with the Nets franchise for quite some time. Too bad his first four NBA seasons were wasted by playing on such lousy teams. Brooklyn made the playoffs in 2013-14 and 15, then won just 21 games in 2015-16, a season that saw Lopez score 20.6 points, 7.8 rebounds, and 2 assists per game. Going back to the 2009-10 season, Lopez has averaged at least 17.2 points per game every season. Too bad the Nets are pretty awful now, otherwise people would vote for him more in All-Star games. Number 8, Hassan Whiteside. Whiteside had two forgettable years with the Sacramento Kings, but emerged as a stud with the Miami Heat in 2014-15. That season saw him break out with 11.8 points and a ridiculous 10 rebounds per game. Whiteside helped the Heat win 48 games and qualify for the playoffs in 2016, averaging 14.2 points and 11.8 rebounds per game. Sadly, Dwayne Wade left Miami in the offseason and Chris Bosh's health sidelined him for 2016-17. As a result, Whiteside is the only exciting thing on a now terrible Miami team. Number 7, Dirk Nowitzki. The longtime Dallas Mavericks star has done everything in his power for the franchise. His greatest moment was helping them win the 2011 NBA championship, but this is the end of the line for the Dirk era. The Mavericks haven't won a playoff series since beating the Heat in the 2011 NBA Finals. The Mavs are now among the league's worst teams, even though Dirk's putting up double-digit points and over 5 rebounds per game. It's a shame to see Dirk and Dallas fade out with such poor play, but it's impressive he's been around this long with his enormous stature and minutes played. Number 6, Andre Drummond. Drummond broke out with 13.5 points and 13.2 points per game in 2013-14. Too bad the Detroit Pistons only won 29 games that year. Drummond then elevated his totals to 13.5 rebounds and 13.8 points per game the following season. Ensured the Pistons made the playoffs in 2016, but a 44-38 record isn't all that spectacular. Drummond is getting better every season, but the Pistons are going nowhere if they can't build around their franchise star. Hopefully Motown doesn't keep wasting his prime years. Number 5, Carmelo Anthony. The New York Knicks are like every superhero movie these days. All hype, all talk, and nothing to show for it. Carmelo Anthony is a generational superstar, but he seems to love the spotlight too much in New York to the point where he doesn't want to leave it. The aging veteran is still putting up well over 20 points and 6 rebounds per game. He remains one of the league's elite small forwards. The Knicks were among the NBA's worst teams in 2014-15 and 16. Doesn't look like things will get better for Melo unless he wants to leave. Number 4, Karl-Anthony Towns. It's a unique situation for Towns. His Timberwolves are terrible right now, but Andrew Wiggins and Zach LaVine should help Towns make the T-Wolves a super team before long. That being said, right now, the Timberwolves are still just what we said, terrible. Towns had 18.3 points and 10.5 rebounds per game in his rookie season, and that's only the beginning. It's only a matter of time until the terrible Timberwolves become the terrifying Timberwolves. Number 3, Jimmy Butler. Despite Butler's best efforts, the Chicago Bulls failed to make the playoffs in 2016. They wasted his career year that saw him post 20.9 points, 4.8 assists, and 5.3 rebounds per game. Man, Butler was like an MVP candidate. But the Bulls put that to waste. Bringing Dwayne Wade on board hasn't made the Bulls better this season either. If this continues, Butler may have to choose between playing in the beautiful city or chasing championships elsewhere. Because he sure isn't going to win much in Chicago anytime soon, unless they recruit Blake Griffin, so good luck with that. Number 2, Anthony Davis. The 2012 first overall pick has been everything the New Orleans Pelicans had hoped for. Like a fine wine, he gets better with age, improving his points and rebound totals over each season. But Davis's club has made the playoffs just once since drafting him, and that led to a first-round sweep at the hands of the Golden State Warriors in 2015. Davis is a bona fide star, but the supporting cast around him is awful, and so are the Pelicans as a team. We're somewhat amazed that he's happy playing there, because he could win a whole lot more on almost any other team. And number 1, DeMarcus Cousins. Cousins is a superstar, no ifs, ands, or buts about it. He's averaged 20-plus points per game in four straight seasons and has easily averaged more than 10 rebounds per game in his career. Cousins is a game-changer around the rim at both ends of the court, but since he broke into the NBA back in 2010, the Kings haven't recorded more than 33 wins in a season. He's simply a one-man team, and the Kings are silly not to trade him and tank for first overall picks. Cousins is arguably a top 10 NBA player. He just isn't getting the recognition because his team is awful. What other NBA stars are on bad teams? Join us in the comments below. If you like this video and learned a thing or two, clicking the like button helps us out a ton and we appreciate it. If this is your first time coming around to Total Pro Sports, though, subscribing is a great idea because we put out videos like this every single day. But as always, thanks for watching and we'll see you guys next time.